Hi, today we are going to talk about Google Cloud Platform. So, what is this platform, why we use it, and what is all services that is included in this platform?
The first thing I am going to do is to define what is Google Cloud Platform. It's a public cloud-based machine whose services are delivered to customer on as you pay as you go. By way of services compound, a public cloud lets you leverage its resources to empower the application you build, as well as to reach a broader base of customers. All through, Google does offer a virtual machine hosting services similar to Amazon and Azure. Its primary service model is based around the development and the deployment of the application. Google Cloud Platform strategy for computing on price is to offer discount for sustained, customized, and committed use. The target core user at present appear to be the business, like small, medium, or large business, that is well into its journey to modern application model and need a more cost-effective and efficient means of deploying them.
Why Google Cloud Platform? Let's discover this together. The first thing that is offering a better price than the concurrent. A global private fiber optic network dedicated for the cloud services. Live migration of a virtual machine, improved performance, state-of-the-art security dedicated to expansion, and redundant backup. How about a Google Cloud Platform services? Google Compute Engine competes directly against the services that put Amazon Web Services on the map. Hosting virtual machine, VMs, server that exist entirely as a software. The next services is a Kubernetes engine. It's a platform for a more modern form of containerized application, which is generated for deployment on cloud platform. The next services is a app engine, provided a software development with tool and language such as Python, PHP, and now even Microsoft .NET language for building and developing a web application directly on Google Cloud. This is different from building the application locally and deploying it remotely on the cloud. This is a cloud-native development, building, deploying, and involving the application all remotely. The next services is a cloud storage. A data store, meaning it accepts any quantity of data and represents that data to its user in whatever manner is most useful. For example, as a file, as a database, as a stream, as an ordered list of data, or as a multimedia. Nearline services is a way to utilize Google Cloud Storage for backup and archival data. The kind that you would necessarily consider a database may only be accessed once by one user. Anantos is a service that is announced last April. It's a Google Cloud Platform system for organizing and maintaining applications that may be centralized around Google. BigQuery is a data warehousing system using Google Cloud Storage, designed for a very large quantity of highly distributed data, enabling SQL queries to execute across multi-database of varying structure level. Rather than a traditional row-based recorded-oriented SQL relation database index, BigQuery utilizes a column storage system in which compound of records are staked onto one other stream of parallel storage. Cloud Bigtable services. Formerly Bigtable is a highly distributed data system that organizes related data into a multi-dimensional assembly of key value based on the large-scale storage for its own use in storing search index. Such an assembly is easier for analytic application to manage than every large index for a closed relational database, with multi-table whose record would have to be joined at query time. The next services is a cloud SQL, not yet really for a public consumption. Host must more traditional relation database and indexes using a Google Cloud Engine instance that scale itself up to meet the database performance demand. Cloud translation, text-to-speech and speech-to-text, as their name it suggests, leverage Google existing capability for speaker and write language management for use in a customer application. APG services is a modeling system for producing and managing API, using the web as a medium of communication. An APG user may model, test and deploy mechanisms for their existing web apps. Cloud AutoML is a suite of services geared to enable application to leverage machine learning. And the Cloud RAN is newly announced services enabling software developer to stage and deploy their application to Google Cloud using the called serverless model, building and running program with the appearance of being hosted locally instead of in cloud. This is far from a complete list of Google Cloud platform services. Through it does introduce you to a major entry. And thank you for watching this session about the Google Cloud Platform. See you next time.